Hey everybody, welcome to Saturday Night Songs, special episode with the Krieber family in Ottawa. So if you're hearing a little bit of an echo, that's because we're not just broadcasting to the ear, we're also broadcasting to the entire Krieber family. So say hi everyone.
Hello!
There you go. Well, and of course among the Krieber family today, we've got Michelle and Monique. Why don't you guys say hi?
Hi there!
Hello.
And how is Ottawa treating you?
Sorry?
How are things going?
Oh, well, let me tell you this. There's a lot of snow, and that was very exciting. It was like, I'd say the snow was like, they were kind of like walnuts falling from, they were so giant. Like, I don't think I've ever seen snow that big.
Big chunks of snowflakes.
And I made a snowman with my cousin's baby Sawyer, and he had a pipe, and he had a hat, and he had a tie, and it was a perfect snow. It was like, it was not too thin, but not too icy. It was just like the best snow ever, and there was tons of it, tons of stuff.
Now the question is, did you have to shovel any of it?
Some people
shoveled.
You know,
mostly granddad.
I heard laughter. I assume somebody.
You know, shoveling. See, I actually do like shoveling, but yeah, I didn't really do it this time. But I kind of feel guilty now.
She's a good shoveler.
But I can get down in the depths of the white stuff.
Okay, why the snowman?
Exactly. That was my thing. You know, I think I did my part. You know.
Well, you know, that is an important role to play. I should say, too, while we get here, that there who are listening right now, be sure to go tweet that you are listening to Saturday Night Songs. Go tweet and use the hashtag Saturday Night Songs. We're actually using a logical hashtag this week. What's going on?
Say that again, Mike?
I said logical hashtag. This is weird to me.
Instead of jungle X, you mean?
Yeah, instead of jungle ducks or undisclosed jazz hands or.
Wait, did we make that one a hashtag?
I don't think we've done that yet.
Oh, we're gonna have to do that.
And Danny's already made Rock the Coat.
Rock the Coat, or just Coat, as he's
said. Yeah, his name. Well, that's his name, Coat.
I think we need to start undisclosed jazz hands, though. That's. Yeah, we need to.
My fear is that people are gonna spell it all wrong. Yeah. I don't know that they've disclosed how to spell that properly yet. It's a terrible, terrible joke. Well, and I should say, too, that this stream has a lot of people who are joining from the Bronies for Good stream. So everybody out there who's been listening all day, we just had Sibzy on, and who's been donating towards Bronies for Good and what they've been doing. They've already raised well over 680 euros today, which is a great, great job for everybody. Welcome to the show.
Congratulations. Good work on that.
Well, so obviously I mentioned a moment ago that Michael Krieber is there, but you also have a few other Kriebers that we haven't met before. Why don't you introduce
why don't you go, Mom? Why don't you go around the circle?
I think you should introduce your own family. Just go around the circle. Start with your fuzzy dog Max there.
Okay, we have
work alone.
We have Maxi Boy, who is familiar. You know, he puts his little tidbits in around the radio show. You know, the few little barks, few little rustles. You know, just in there.
Collar jangling.
Exactly. So first we have my cousin Doug, who is actually a really great musical theater performer, and then we have my Aunt Kathy. And then we have, my dad there. And then we have Ook, who actually has a credit on my album. He's my part-time chauffeur. Right, Ook?
Found my place.
Yes. And you might recognize him from the Spies in the Night video. Have we actually released the whole thing yet?
What's his name? Malibial?
Nefario.
January 12th, we're premiering Speedy and Stretch. So the whole, some of them will have seen it like on the Everfree Northwest broadcast and that kind of thing. And no, I think he's also in the trailer, aren't you? Isn't there a scene with you in the trailer? Yeah. So, but they will see much more of the evil side when we release the entire thing.
Yes.
Nefario.
And then we have my Uncle Ernie. And I think I talked about his famous duck one time on the show. I think we did.
She described your whole.
I talked about the Peking duck that he made.
The Peking duck. Oh, better. More tasty than that.
And then we have my cousin Jeff. And then we have...
otherwise known as the father of Sawyer.
Yes. That's why he's classified. When Jeff was telling the story how someone sent a letter to Jeff and his wife Courtney's and Sawyer's house, and it just said Sawyer on it. And it said... so what did it say, Jeff?
Say hello to those old people that look after you once in a while.
Those old people that are in their 20s. But then, you see, now Jeff knows how it feels when... when we had you, Michelle, then it was no longer Monique and Michael, and we're not, you know, musicians anymore or performers. We're just Michelle's parents.
We're drivers.
Yeah. And just like Chris, you know, now he's Michelle's driver.
Oh, he's also a great percussionist. You know, he does a he's kind of a one trick pony, but there you go. Right, ready, go
that's
ahead.
A dolphin. Now,
there
you,
was a pond.
You've heard the summer that's dolphin, but this is a winter dolphin.
Anybody can guess how he does that? I don't know.
Maybe we should give them a digital download if they can guess. You should come and do it closer to the mic. And this is going to be a bonus contest on the spot here. And anybody, if there's anybody who can guess how he creates this dolphin sound, then we will give you a digital download of a Creeper Christmas. Awesome. Here we go, Uncle Chris.
Okay, here we go. Me and my dolphin.
Can you hear that, Mike? Does it come through the microphone?
I can hear it, and it is significantly crazy, yes. I have a friend who's a big fan of dolphins and porpoises and whales and orcas and all that. And I think that that would challenge his best beluga impression. I think it would.
Excellent.
So congratulations. Yeah.
And a few more family members, Michelle?
Yep. And then we have my grandma Tina, who is, of course, the head chef of the family, and she is amazing. Like, she's just, you can't even describe the meals she makes. It's just amazing. Yeah, you know? Grandma. Like, it's just...
let's have a hand for grandma's awesome cooking.
And, of course, grandma and granddad are always the hosts of Christmas, and they look after all of us and make sure we don't get out of hand. Well, you know, if you can even...
if that's possible. Us,
if you can just...
don't tell we succeed either.
Yes. And then, of course, we have my granddad, and he is actually... well, I think we've talked about this quite a bit before, but...
I remember Grandma and Granddad were actually on the show briefly time when they were visiting us in Vancouver.
In laughter mode only.
In laughter mode, that's right.
Yeah. My little donkey. We talked about my little donkey, Aunt Kathy.
Well, the military bronies that are listening in, we're very excited to hear that Granddad, who is a retired Major General, is going to be with us this evening, so they have been sending messages about that.
Yeah,
so,
and he's going to
special welcome to Granddad from them.
Yes, and he's going to explain a little bit more about what he did in the Army, and we'll get to that later though. And then last but not least, we have this guy. His name is Andrew. He's kind of weird, but you know, I guess I could call him my brother. You know, he's kind of. I don't really want to go that far because he's kind of. You know.
He ain't heavy.
The love that I'm hearing right now.
This
breaks
Andrew,
the heart.
And he is officially. You know, we have a lot of dudes in this family. You know, everyone calls each other dude. You know, we have Ook dude, we have Jeff dude, we have Dad dude, we have Doug dude.
We have Grand dude and Grand dude,
and then we have, you know, Sawyer dude, and then Mini dude, Dog dude, and then we have Dude. This is Dude, people.
Dude's the original. The dude.
I am Mini Dude, and then Sawyer is Miniature Dude, I think, now.
He'd be Micro Dude.
Micro Dude. And see, if there was ever a smaller one, it could be Nano Dude.
Micro Dude will be back in a minute with his mom, Courtney.
Oh, yeah, and then we have to introduce Courtney, who is Jeff's wife and also the mother of...
And Grace is at work today, right?
So
Grace is not here. Michelle's other cousin, Grace. Yes.
Are you saying that she couldn't grace us with her presence? I had to to it.
Wow.
Grace could not grace.
That was so punny, Mike.
It was really bad. You know, I think sometimes when you get these really bad puns, you know, they kind of gnaw at the back of your head, and you have to let them loose, otherwise they're going to keep dogging you. I don't know.
Exactly.
It's just terrible.
So I think we got everybody. Oh, we didn't introduce Marley, the other dog.
Marley's here.
There we go. Okay, now we've got everybody, including the two dogs.
Well, all right. Well, we're actually going to keep moving here because we've got a lot to get through. But
yeah, the family introductions took half the show.
There no, that's okay. That's okay. I'm actually excited for this because I'm seeing on my schedule here that next up, Michael is going to play Linus and Lucy. And I know he's an amazing piano player, so I'm really looking forward to this.
Awesome. I'm going to do a little rendition. Are you ready?
All right. Is everybody ready out there?
Yeah, here we go.
Dancing?
Father and I paid thousands of dollars for a classic piano.
Wasted piano.
From the time we were living in Texas when he was 2 years old, and he demanded a local pianist in a restaurant to sing Roses of Texas.
Roses of Texas?
That's what he learned.
Oh.
You know the yellow rose of Texas?
Yeah.
And from that time on, we knew that he was going to be some kind of a pianist in his fingers.
Some kind.
Yeah.
We haven't let Mike say anything yet.
Oh, I was just going to say that was amazing. And that, you know, as a piano student in my youth, and somebody who used to think I could play piano, it's always good to hear somebody play that song properly, because that's one of those songs everybody always asks for, you know? Like, hey, play the Snoopy song.
Play the Snoopy song.
Yeah, play that Charlie Brown thing, you know, all the time. That or Bohemian Rhapsody, but anyway.
Next year for that.
Come on, buddy.
What were you going to say, Michelle?
Well, do we have the micro dude? Where is everybody going? All of a sudden, like, half of the room is gone. This family has the lowest attention span ever.
That might explain some things.
you'll see that Michelle comes by her attention span and her randomness awesomely. I mean,
Awesome.
Including her English skills.
And English skills
and
as well.
Honestly.
Her English not so good.
See, there you go.
Speak not good so much.
Case in point.
We don't have a way with words.
Thank you so much.
Others don't have way.
We don't have way.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay, just remember, we won't be able to hear Mike unless we be quiet in between. We have to let a lull for him to jump in.
Oh, no, I'm just going to sit back and allow, you know?
Are you going to be an enabler, Mike?
Facilitator.
You know, I've been called many things, but an enabler.
Enabler being one of them.
Yeah. Actually, you know, I think I have been called that once or twice. You know, I was going to say, though, for people who don't know, Michael Krieber is a really accomplished pianist. I mean, he has an entire career that has since been trumped by Michelle Krieber, of course. But no, he has an entire career.
Right out the window.
Gosh. But it always surprises somebody in the stream when I reveal that you co-wrote Banana Phone with Rafi. Rafi, how does he pronounce
Rafi?
It? Is it Rafi?
Rafi. Rafi.
Rafi. See, I always said Rafi as a kid. I don't know why.
It's an Armenian name, Rafi. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, so there you go. Like, people don't know that. I should also clarify for people who are listening that there's a little bit of an echo on my voice, but that's just because they have to have their microphones set up in such a way that so many creepers can be heard. So if you're hearing that echo, can't be helped. It's okay. Survived. But anyway, yeah. No, so moving along. Is Michelle going to go get a micro creeper then? Is that the plan here?
Well, here's the deal.
They have like a whistle where everyone comes into the room. Yeah.
His dad, Jeff, is going to check to see if micro dude...
He's willing.
Well, not a willing thing. It's just so far past his bedtime. It's more like, survive it through this or has he crashed and fallen asleep? So they're just going to check.
If Michelle hasn't made it to the next province already, we could ask her a few questions about, you know, today's episode that was aired.
That's a great idea. I will see how far she made it. Michelle!
She's probably somewhere near Montreal right now.
That's only 60 miles.
Yeah, she's back in Vancouver already.
Here she is.
She's back for questions.
All right. Well, so Michelle, today Apple Family Reunion aired, and I know a lot of people in the chat, you know, especially because we had Cindy Morrow, who's the writer of the episode, and we just talked to Sidzi, who did the art for it. A lot of people who want to know what your impressions of the episode were now that it's come out and is aired. Like, that's a
I haven't had time to watch it yet, Mike. I don't even think I watched last week. What was last week's?
Last week's was Wonderbolt Academy.
Oh, I didn't watch that either. Oh, I wanted to watch that. That's a good episode.
Well, you did some singing in this episode today.
Yeah, I did. I had that recording session with Ashley about a year ago.
Well, I was talking with your mom a little bit earlier before the program, and it just seemed kind of appropriate that, you know, the episode is all about this Apple family getting together, and, you know, you've got the grandparents and the cousins and all that, and that whole storyline. And here you are on this program with all of your family there. It just seemed like an interesting parallel.
It was really coincidental. I couldn't believe it because I actually did watch it this morning when I realized which episode it was because I remembered reading the script when she recorded it. And it really was so appropriate for the show that we're doing today. And there's actually a little piece at the end that was particularly appropriate that that we can share later on.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, so...
So it turns out Micro Dude has gone to bed, and he's out of commission, would you say, Dad?
I would say he's not in a state where he would be pleasant.
Now, keeping in mind that Micro Dude is only turning 3 next week, this is way past his bedtime, so they gave it the old college try to see if we could keep him up to 10 Eastern. So we will proceed with the story, and, you know, anybody who has the album
A Priestly Christmas. It's a Gregorian chant album.
And anybody who has a Krieber Christmas or has heard it or will hear it after this will hear his sweet little voice in the beginning when Michelle and I are reading the story. That is indeed Micro Dude, also known as Sawyer, who is doing all of the interjections when we do our story. So we will read this in honor of Sawyer, and then we will let him hear it on YouTube when the episode comes out. How's that?
I think that has to be a plan. Sounds good.
Oh, that was my knee. Oh, if we I mean my. Order,
well, so whenever
so
you guys
I
are ready.
I will kind of conduct the family and sort of point to people when it's their verse and that kind of thing. Do we have everyone else that's in? And we'll replace that. Yeah. Okay. All right. So, everybody ready? And excellent. And you guys should probably be in closer to the microphone. You three gentlemen there. Okay. Oh, and yeah, maybe cell phones could.
It's a Christmas tradition, you know. It dates back to the 17th century.
Yes, cell phones going off in the opera.
Yeah, it's only been recently that it's been iPhones, but yeah.
All right, y'all ready? "'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long, long winter's nap.
And out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from the bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
But the little old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, with coursers they came, he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all!
As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the housetop of coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too.
And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof, the prancing and gnawing of each little goof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler, just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled! His dimples, how merry! His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His bold little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and then the beard of his chin was as white as the snow.
The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed, like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle,
and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight,
"Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Congratulations. you can't applaud and do a push to talk.
I'm applauding. Hey, listen, I'm applauding right here.
There we go.
Is it going to talk?
What's that?
Are we clear?
I don't think we've started the song yet. I think we're going to introduce it first.
I thought I heard Rich's voice in there.
No, we haven't gone to song yet. No.
No, he just decided to interject. Everybody 8-track.
Hello.
Hi, Rich.
Hello.
Oh, that was good. Some people in the chatter seat and they're feeling so cozy and then you just see zzz, you know? Well, okay, so we've got the song The Night Before Christmas and it's off of the album. Again, A Creamer Christmas. It's available on CD Baby. It's not available elsewhere, but of course it's available at michellecreamer.com. And so if you have not gone and gotten it, now is the time. But Rich, if you're there.
Yep.
Maybe we should play the track.
All right, we're ready to go. Here we go. The Night Before Christmas.
"'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
Dash away all."
But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight,
"Merry Christmas!
Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Yeah.
And we're back, and like we mentioned a little bit earlier, actually, we've got a very distinguished member of the Creever family live with us tonight, Major General Creever. And so I just wanted to first, you know, say hi. It was nice to meet you again. But I also wanted to ask you, you know, maybe if you could share with the group, the internet audience, a little bit about your career. You know, being a Major General, it's a very high rank.
Yes, I was very fortunate. I had a very long career of 34 years, but I started off as an electrical engineer with a specialization in things like radar and fire control systems. So my background was technical, and I stayed that way for about the first 15 years. And then over time, I became more involved in managing what I was doing with a lot of other people. So that's my background generally. But my service took me in many places into the United States to study guided weapons, into the United Kingdom to study more and deeper into fire control systems. And then ultimately, I was also, not ultimately, but long ago, 1966, I was posted into Egypt where I had an interesting experience.
What was that experience, Grandad?
The experience in Egypt was I was thrown out. Along with 10,000 other people.
Oh, so you're in good company.
In 1966, the United Nations Emergency Force was still there after 10 years. And in 1967, Colonel Abdel Nasser of Egypt, the president of Egypt at the time, decided that he was going to tell the United Nations that he no longer wanted them in his country. So under the charter that we had, we were obliged to leave. And that was a very interesting time because we were given a month's notice to leave, and ultimately we were only given 10 days to actually get out. So my job was to get my group together, repair all the equipment of the United Nations, and make sure that all the equipment of the various nations that were there got back to them. And fortunately, in the case of Canada, we didn't lose any troops. We got all of our own Canadian equipment back to Canada, and some of it we diverted to Cyprus, where we also had a big action going as well. So that was a very interesting experience to be there in Egypt over that whole year. It had not a very good side effect. I didn't see my family for a whole year, whereas nowadays those postings are only about 6 months, so times have changed.
Oh, did we cut out there for a second? Sorry.
No, I think that was the end. He said times change.
Oh, okay.
A little slow there, Mike.
No, I'm sorry. We've been getting a lot of questions. A couple people in the chat were saying that they were not distinguished enough to speak with you, General. they were commenting. They were saying that, you know, wow, Major General.
I had at one time something like 10,000 people in my own organization. That was the Electrical Mechanical Engineers. And I had no hesitation about speaking to my private soldiers who were craftsmen and very, very good ones at that. So I don't have any difficulty talking to anybody.
So we can vouch for that.
We can vouch for that. He's a very personable, down-to-earth person.
Yeah. Well, and one thing I'll just mention really quickly is you mentioned that you were removed from Egypt. I've actually been thrown out of a country myself, in a much less glorious way.
Tell us, Mike.
This is a true story. In 2005, I was thrown out of the Vatican City because I was wearing shorts, and they require that you wear long pants there, so they wouldn't let me in. But that's not nearly as interesting.
Really?
Did it really?
Did you hear that, Mike?
Same thing happened to
me. I was in my first time in Rome, and I was just walking around the city in my shorts and t-shirt, and I wandered into the Vatican and was asked to leave and come back when I had suitable attire.
Yep. They're very strict about it.
Yeah. Well, and Michael, you got kicked out of a country.
Yeah, but I don't even want to tell that story right now.
Well, no, please do tell.
Do I have
to? His past.
A very fast version.
I hear that Fiji is very forgiving, so.
I was en route to Mexico for a family vacation. The rest of the family was already there.
He didn't do anything wrong.
I was happily just flying along over the Baja Peninsula. I could see the lovely sea below, and I'm going to, you know, see my family and have a few days vacation.
And I started filling out my little form, the customs form. And of course, on the customs form, it said, fill out your passport number. And I did that diligently. And then it said, you know, passport expiry date. So I opened up my passport. I realized it had been expired for 2 weeks.
Oh, no.
Already expired. And I was landing in Mexico. And they've gotten a little tougher about Canadian passports. And so when I landed, they promptly threw a big fuss and five people gathered around me and hustled me back onto the plane, back to Canada.
6 hours back to Canada.
And he had to fly all the way from Mazatlan back to Vancouver. And actually the scary thing about that is that he passed through about 6 passport checks before he even left Canada and then went through LA and they looked at his passport a few more times. Yeah. And no one at any passport check noticed that his passport had expired until he landed in Mazatlan.
Well, because he took two flights, right? He took one from Vancouver to LA and then left right away. So that means that he had to fill out two customs forms.
There's only one form, but it was still...
Michelle, you might not know this, but your grandmother and I arrived. We were in England for a year, 2 years, in fact. And one time we decided to go over to Europe, and we got on a boat. Got to Holland, and while we were on the boat, they looked at our passports, and they said to my wife, Tina, your passport is out of date. And, of course, we thought we both had equivalent passports because we got them at the same time. So we ended up then in about 3 days in The Hague in Holland looking to get a new passport for Tina before we could start our holiday.
Wow.
And it was very interesting because on the first day we wanted to get our pictures taken while the photographers were all closed on Monday.
Oh.
So it went on like that. But ultimately we did get our passports on our spirit. Way. So you know, it runs in the family.
In the family. It's expired passport. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
at least one side of the family.
And there was an even more ignominious experience. When we first moved from Vancouver to Ontario, we went by ship across lake, what lake was it? Over to the States, down, not here. Lake Richardson? No, the one.
Not Lake Superior.
Oh no, it was on Lake Ontario. And the U.S. wouldn't allow me to get in because my passport was out of state. In those days, we had to have passports.
Wow,
we're very diligent.
So not only randomness, but also kicking out of countries. I guess we all, the fish rots at the head. What's that expression?
That's good.
It all filters down. Well, so we're ready to play a name that song contest if you want,
do
Mike.
Do we have the right passport to do that? Do we have the right passport? I mean, we've got to name the song contest, exactly. And how do we want to do this?
So Michael's ready at the piano, and we'll do it like last week, where he's going to play two notes with no rhythm, just two melody notes from this song. And we'll wait, you know, a minute or less than a minute around there, and we will watch Twitter, and it's the same hashtag Jungle Ducks.
All right.
And then he'll do three notes. He'll play the first two and add a third note to it, and just keep doing that with quarter notes to see who can guess what the song title is. And winner will receive a digital download from McCreever Christmas.
Can we guess as well?
No. People in the room cannot guess. Fine. Keep your mouth zipped.
It will be hard.
That's not good.
Am I allowed to guess? Monique, am I allowed to guess? I do have it in front of me, but I just wanted to know.
No, people in your room and in any of the rooms there are not allowed to. And that counts for you too, Sci-Fi. Did we even mention that Sci-Fi is here today?
I thought we had, but if we haven't, hi.
No, I maybe we did, and I missed it. Okay, so you guys all set for the first two notes? Okay, Michael?
Yep, I'm ready. Can
go
I just
for
try
it.
One note?
I think they'll need at least two.
Oh, two.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Can I move
okay. La, la. That's the first two notes.
Okay, loading. Loading.
Checking for her.
Doing anything.
So I forgot to say also at Michelle Creeber. I think they probably got that.
Oh, okay.
At Michelle Creeber, hashtag Jungle Ducks, if you know the title of that song. Check it.
And this is slow.
I wonder if it's because we're using the internet.
Well, you gotta give them a second to guess. I mean, maybe play those two notes again.
Sprock Zathusa. Someone says epic spaceship song from Apollo 11.
Wait a second. Apollo 11. It's Apollo 13.
No, it's not that.
Epic spaceship song from Apollo 11.
I think it's safe to say that this is a holiday song, that this is a seasonal song.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Perhaps I forgot to mention that. It is a Christmas song.
Yeah, it's totally not Thus Spoke Zarathustra.
Thus Spoke Zarathustra.
Okay, guys, how about we add a third note?
It's a song on the album.
Ooh, big hint. Okay, three notes. Quarter notes. Here we go.
If anybody guesses Thus Spoke again, I'm just done. I'm not gonna... And now somebody's going to because I made that comment. I just...
Okay, what I'm seeing here is From Our House to Yours, Chariots of Fire, Frosty the Snowman.
Not the red nose.
Dun 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 dun.
Dreaming of a White Christmas. Got any other ones, Michelle?
Rudolph. Thus spoke Zarathustra while wearing a Santa hat.
There's another one there, Michelle.
Oh, come, Emmanuel. Don't know if it's on there. Oh, come.
Oh, there's Osaka Jack.
Some children see him. That's a good guess. It's actually on the album. Yes.
First, okay, I think we better guess. Add another note.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, Auntie Jacques guessed From Our House to Yours. Okay, that's the second actual relevant guess.
Ready?
Somebody got it.
Oh, it's Violet Wisp again.
Oh my gosh.
Violet Wisp, you are beating out all the other guessers. All the other Timmys and all the other Osakas.
Yes, Tim couldn't be here today.
And the Jacks. Osaka. Okay, I love how people are changing their names. I have Osaka Jack Frost. this is my favorite. Instead of Tim Gropner, Chris Timmis. Gropner. except the T-I-M is in big letters. So it looks like C-H-R-I-S-T-I-M-A-S. And then it's like Chris Timmis. I'm going to see if it's me.
Dusty is now Dusty Claws. Oh, yeah.
What's Sabby's again? Sabby Claws?
Yeah, I think it is.
That makes sense.
Oh my gosh. So Violet Wisp, we're running out of prizes that I can think of to send you, so maybe you could suggest something to me this time. Actually, no, it is a digital download code. That is the prize for this one, so maybe that could be a Christmas gift you give to somebody else,
because
I know you already have it. So.
It's a gift that keeps on giving at least once.
There you go. So it was indeed Someday at Christmas.
Yep.
All right. And from what I'm reading, you guys are actually going to perform that song live.
That's right.
True.
Well, whenever you're ready.
Michelle and Michael are going to perform it right now.
There we go.
Alrighty then. I'll give you a little intro. Here we go.
Someday at Christmas, won't be boys playing with fun to let kids play with toys. One December, our hearts will see a world All men are equal and no man have fears. One shining moment my heart ran away from the world today. Someday all our dreams will come to be. Someday in a world where men are free. Maybe not in time for you and me, but someday at Christmas time.
Now, 8-track, did you get the applause covered there that time?
Yeah, I got it. It's cool.
Okay, just making sure, because I can only do like this kind of like weird, you know, noise if I try. That was amazing, guys. You guys are awesome. Some people in the chat were saying, Draft, you should sing, and I said, no. No.
That's a bad idea.
This is a really bad idea. No, that was really good. Well, so we've already named the contest winners. I think really quick, I would like to remind everybody who are listening that this is, aside from being a special Saturday Night Songs with the whole Creeper family, it also is part of the larger Bronies for Good charity stream that's been going on. So if you guys haven't, please go and donate to Bronies for Good. They are doing some amazing work. I don't know what they're at right now, but I know it's well over 680 euros, which is quite a bit of money. And then furthermore, for those of you who are tuned in about 40 minutes or so, we are going to have Lauren Faust on the line. So it's going to be pretty cool. So stay tuned for that as well. But I like how on the schedule that I'm looking at, because here's a little bit of behind the scenes for everybody who's listening. You know, we have a schedule. You know, we have things that we need to, you know, go through and discuss, and et cetera, for the program. Right now, I'm looking at number 12, and it says randomness and goofiness. And I like how that's on the schedule. It's almost like
No. You gotta read the whole thing. Randomness and goofiness is a family trait.
It says Michelle.
This one says Michelle comes by honestly. Discuss.
I think we have to say it like Michael Myers in Coffee Talk.
Exactly.
So randomness and goofiness is a family trait. Michael comes by it honestly. Discuss.
No, Michelle.
Well, I just assumed Michael as well.
Well, Michelle is the
Coffee Talk.
Coffee Talk, you know. Don't get full clemmed.
No big whoop.
It's no big whoop. That's right. It's like butter. Well, but so this is on there. Discuss. Please explain.
Who put this on there, Mom?
Actually, to be honest, it's Sci-Pi who noticed that as he was helping me create the agendas, he noticed that there was enough randomness that happens in every episode that he deemed it wise to actually schedule some randomness to try to keep things on track.
Planned randomness.
So no.
It never works.
It doesn't work. No.
Okay, everybody, let's be goofy.
Be random. Let us be random.
And action.
Be normal. Well, the rest of the family was thinking that maybe they would plan one of the family board games at the table beside us, which would have meant that you would have never heard
you
anything.
No, that's a problem. No, it's great. No, okay. Well, it's in the middle. You can't really tell. No.
I think you guys.
We always put the lines on the Cluedo. No. We always put the lines. No. Wait. No. Shut your mouth. It's
word.
A sexo sketch.
It's not in the Oxford English Dictionary. It's not a word.
It's in the Scrabble Dictionary.
It's Scrabble.
Fine.
No, there's no way. I am a Scrabble hound.
This is the thing that happens in a game.
Go there.
me into this.
That's ridiculous. That's not a word. I'm a bubble. What is that?
Random.
What is that?
Now, that was.
That's actually controlled chaos.
It is barely controlled.
I'm not How is Spider National Gallery funny? How is that not funny?
Explain. How is this not funny?
We have a giant spider in front of our National Gallery.
No, yeah.
I saw a picture.
It's a National Gallery of spiders.
I saw a picture on the net. I thought, well, it must be the National Spider Gallery. Everybody loves spiders.
Oh, everyone loves arachnids.
Especially 20-foot spiders.
How is it that Jeff can have a moment of silence like this?
Oh, yeah, now Jeff shows up one time he's silent. Time.
He used to be when he entered your room, there's nobody else could be heard.
Dad, he didn't have to be in the room.
Just as long as he's in the same city.
No, I just signed up for this tweeter machine or something and made my first tweet. So
I retweeted it.
Michelle's uncle, Micro Dude's dad, just signed up for Twitter. What's your handle?
Wong Jeff M.
Oh, I see that.
I mean, Michelle's cousin.
It's the second time you've done that.
He looks like
me. I'm losing my mind. Okay, Michelle's cousin, Jeff, is now signed up for Twitter at Wong Jeff
M.
So WONGJEFF
M. For Michael.
M for Michael. Go follow Jeff Wong on Twitter.
Well, Jeff used to throw me out. Like, he used to go.
Throw you out?
Yeah, I was going to say.
Michelle for one game.
Well, we used to take turns throwing
right
around.
We don't need another one.
No, he used to throw me up in the air. He does this with Sawyer now. In the front foyer of my grandparents' house, which is like 5 feet away from us right now. So it's like. It's kind of like an uncle, you know, that type of. It's kind of
no
more casual
dishes.
Like an uncle.
It's basically
taking
like
nowhere,
a better parent, you know?
Yeah, better parent.
I'm just the cool uncle.
Sorry, Mike, were you trying to say anything in there?
I don't think that if I...
Wait, are we still on?
Yes.
Shut up.
Yes.
Now we're just being
weird. It's like Dad's birth sheet. Testing. Is this
and
long?
Keenan's checkbook of randomness check.
Mike is trying to say something. What, Mike?
No, that time it was Rich. What checkbook there?
I was going to say Keenan's random checkbook of randomness check.
There we go. Well, I was going to say, people have been linking that spider that you guys were talking about. Apparently, it's been around the world. It's been at the Tate Modern. It's been at the National Gallery, of course. But it's been at the Hermitage Museum in St. Petersburg, the Guggenheim in Bilbao in Spain. It's been everywhere.
Oh,
what?
I guess it's
sort of like
Vlad
Stanley. It's the Vlad Stanley of the spider world.
And apparently,
I love Vlad Stanley. I made a Vlad Stanley.
No,
I made a laminated Vlad Stanley in grade 3. That was fun. I still have him.
Or it's like Chris Lampard.
He could slide under doors, and he flew away.
That's pretty amazing.
Like
every hour
show.
Every hour show he goes around the room.
I like when he said, I like what you've done with the place.
I literally have no idea what you're referring to right now.
Oh, sorry.
There you go. Creeper randomness.
That's how it is here.
But you see that now you know where Michelle gets it from. That was That's what we were trying to illustrate.
I'm not alone here, people. I'm amongst insane. It's just insane here.
You might be the most sane out of all of us, actually.
Not all people in Ottawa are like this.
Well, you know, this actually leads into a question. This leads into a question, actually, that Osaka Jack asked, and he said, you know, first he complimented the singing that was happening a little bit earlier, but he also wanted to say, what traits do all creepers share? Like, do you guys have any kind of just family similarities, or is it the randomness thing?
Traits.
We all like treats, actually. That is a treat. We all like treats.
There we go.
We like banana bars. We like Smarties. We like Hershey's Kisses.
We're all very serious people.
I can tell.
Very reserved.
Quiet.
Nobody has any opinion.
That's some.
Yes. Yeah. That's right. No one has
any opinion. Yeah. There's no contrary at all.
Not contrary.
Grandmother speaking.
Like grandmother.
Somebody who's been around for a long time and have known all these people from the time they have. There being very little, I can say that we're getting to the point where Okay, now you know they'd love to. They'd love to say something, but I'm not allowing them. We're getting to the point where this old adage works. When you live with people for a long time, you begin to look like them.
That's true.
And another thing, all this technology with Twittering and with U-Face and
U-Face.
U-Twit-Face.
That's right.
Well, let her finish your sentence. All the final donkeys.
They're a real mystery, and I'm trying very, very hard to keep up. And I can say that getting a master's degree in Russian and getting and studying languages was far easier than this time.
No, that's right. Mike is Russian. Tina has a master's degree in Russian.
Oh, yeah, I just heard that. Yeah, I'm half Russian, actually. My dad's side. Я не говорю по-русски хорошо.
Я хорошо?
Да, нет, нет, очень плохо.
Well, хорошо.
No, нет, хорошо. Okay, so people who wondered what we just said there, she asked if I spoke Russian, and I said not very well, or at least I tried to say not very well, but I said not very well, not very well. I said that I actually speak it quite horribly. No, that's interesting, actually. My family on my father's side is Russian, and that's actually how my parents met, was through the Russian department at the University of Minnesota. So, yeah, my mom actually got a master's degree in Russian. So,
Minnesota.
Yep.
Yeah, I went down to Minneapolis to do a lot of research for my... my
master's degree there.
Well, no.
Slavonics.
For what I have to write, yeah.
It was very, very interesting.
Yeah.
Well, if it was sometime anywhere between the late 70s and the early 90s, you probably ran into some people my mom knows. So there you go. It's a small world.
Right.
Much earlier, 60s.
Well, there you go. I should say we've got a little bit of time for questions, people, in the chat. So if you have any questions for any of the Creamers, I think, and of course for Michelle or for myself, please private message them to me within the IRC, and I will go through them. But, did you take Russian then, and then say, did you ever visit the Soviet Union? I'm just curious.
Did you ever visit the Soviet Union, Tina?
No, almost. Yes. Well, yeah. You went to St. Louis. But I studied other languages, too, countries of which I visited more often than Russia.
But recently, St. Petersburg.
St. Petersburg.
And I was there about 5 years ago.
And what is supposed to be Ukraine, but it's Russia, still Russian dominated somehow, Sevastopol and Yalta, that area.
Oh, okay.
Partly because we're also interested in history, and it's interesting to visit places like that.
Yeah, my dad is from Odessa, actually, in the Ukraine, but he's ethnically Russian.
We were there about 3 years ago now.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. What I noticed about Odessa is that in the touristy part of town, it's very beautiful, but if you go anywhere outside of that, it's just a train wreck. It's just crumbling buildings everywhere. It's kind of a shame.
Just like in Istanbul.
Yeah, I was actually in Istanbul just a year ago.
Oh, yeah, we've been there 2 or 3 times. But I have been a guide at the War Museum for many years because of history, from the point of view of history, not because of the fact that there have been battles. Although we talk about the fact that Canada has grown up by participating. But because of that, I like to go to places where we can talk about in the museum to high school students. And going to Istanbul and those places has something to do with Gallipoli, which, of course, is very famous for Australians and New Zealanders. And then we go off to places that are famous for Canadians. So all in all, it's very interesting.
Okay, so that's very interesting, Grandma. Thank you for that.
Well, no, it's actually quite fascinating. I'm a history nerd, so I know what she's talking about. It's Gallipoli. That was one place I wanted to go when I was in Turkey, but I didn't get a chance to. But we've got a few questions here. I'm going to just say, Cameramere Jack wants to know, how were the meetups in Ottawa and Vancouver for you guys, the brony meetups you did?
Well, yeah, I mean, specifically, they were meet and greets for Michelle for her, you know, for the CDs. And we had a great brony contingent at both of them come. And both of them were very successful, and we met lots of great people. In Vancouver, we had met a lot of the fans from Vancouver before, because there have been various events that we've been to, and then Everfree Northwest, many of them came up for that. But I think in Ottawa, it was safe to say that we hadn't met any of them before, and we had a nice crowd of people come to the mall today.
We had about 50.
I think 40 to 50 people dropped by, yeah. And lots of, you know, questions and pictures.
Lots of confused people wondering about what this giant group of guys is doing with pony shirts on around a little girl in her pants. Wait. At a Blend's coffee shop.
No, second cup.
Well, hopefully you clarified that.
Anyway, no, it was great. They were awesome.
All right, so right now, oh, Mike, were you going to say something?
Well, I got another very important question. This is from Abian47, and they ask a question for all the Creebers. How did you guys spend the apocalypse yesterday?
Eating.
Yeah.
Having
our last
meal.
Wait, talking as usual. Dim sum and ragu. Yes. Nice. High five. We both said ragu.
It's a rewrite of the Christmas song. Yeah.
We created our own food apocalypse.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't have the amount of food that we ate.
What's the word about too much?
Oh, it's you know, we discovered this word that the English language needs is shimama jamo. I think it's I believe it's Danish or Finnish, and it means eating to the point past of which you're full, eating just because it tastes good.
The Creeper Christmas is
shimama jamo. We're gonna write a song about it.
You know, if you guys do follow that philosophy often, the Romans had a special area of their villas, you know, called the vomitorium, where they could clear the palate, as it were, yes, so they could keep eating.
You don't go quite that far.
Oh, no.
Yes, we
try to eat.
We just go, oh. Yeah.
We eat too much, then we whine.
We eat a lot and have a good wine.
With good wine.
With good
That's
wine.
Right.
Having a good wine.
Okay, so are we going to sing a song now?
You can if you'd like to, yes.
Okay. yes, that's right. We do have a song.
Or we can talk about C223 Corporations Tax Return, which is the other side of the the lyric sheet we have here.
Now, hold on. Someone don't talk about that. Michelle, could you sing about it?
I won't put any undisclosed information.
Oh, okay.
What?
Singing back to me.
Sorry, okay. Okay. What do I do?
I was just joking around. I was saying if you're going to read off that form,
We're going to do Silent Night.
There we go.
And we don't have Natalie, and we don't have Mando Pony with us here today. So instead of that, we have Monique and Michelle's cousin Doug.
Hello.
Who's also a great singer. And we've done four. And we have the entire family chorus. So what we're going to do, I actually haven't told them this yet. Honestly, that's the way we run a really tight ship around here. And so the way it's going to work is Michelle will sing the way she normally does. And then I will, Douglas and I will take over for some of it. We're going to do the three verses anyway, the three of us. And then we're going to repeat verse one in a new key, just like on the CD, where the whole family can join in if they're so inclined.
And
a very tight ship. But we use that analogy, you know, very loose. You say, I mean, you know,
we use the tight ship loosely.
Yeah,
yeah,
like
but we're not ironic or anything.
But listen, we do have to sing well so we can sing a Christmas evening.
Extravaganza.
Choral. Yes, we want to sing along with the choirs on Christmas Eve, so we have to practice for that.
There are great choirs here.
Yes. Yeah, in A and then one in B.
Oh, three in A. It's just two and then one B.
No, it's three in A. Oh, I see. It's two in A and then two in B.
Okay.
Right.
Two.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Are we
repeating this one? Like we usually
Yeah, we'll do it just like the album.
Okay.
Oh, and by the way, we should say, Mike, I don't know if you've seen it, but we did upload the Silent Night video to Michelle's YouTube channel, and she sent out something about that, I think it was yesterday. But there is a video with Michelle and Natalie and Andy performing it now on her YouTube channel that's gotten lots of great feedback. So everybody can check that out on Michelle Creever on YouTube on her channel.
Is Dougie going to sing this little
bit? Yeah, we're going to kind of wing it.
Yeah, well,
yeah. Okay. Here we go. So you just do what you normally do.
Okay.
Wing it.
Round yon bird.
And as per usual, Rich has the
I have
covered.
To chime in.
Well, no, you do. No, no, it's good. It's good. I mean, that was really... Wait, chime in? Okay, never mind. Well, and I actually should say during the song, somebody did send me a very decent pun. He wanted me to make sure to tell everyone over there in Ottawa a Merry Creebermas. And he wanted me to make sure that I could draft that into the... I'm just... whatever. But anyway, well, I think we're going to get this pretty much wrapped up here. I want to thank all of you guys for joining us today. You know, it looks like you're... Well, I should say it sounds like it sounds... You guys are having a great time over there. You know, I know a lot of people are envious of having your entire gathering there. So, you know, I hope you guys have a great holiday.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Help, I'm trapped in this crazy house.
Love you. It's like in the producers.
Get me out.
Do I hear somebody run say, away. Get me out?
Call the Humane Society.
Yeah, it's well, you know, I'm we're online, so you know, from one crazy assemblage of people to another, you know, happy Creepermas, and for all of you guys who are tuned in online, be sure if you haven't done this already to go and get a copy of A Creeper Christmas, because a portion of the proceeds is going to go towards Planet International's Because I Am a Girl campaign. Also, of course, today we're doing a large live stream for Bronies for Good, so go and help them out as well if you can. In a few minutes here, we're going to have Lauren Faust online. But again, thanks, Michelle. Thanks, Monique. Thanks, Creebers. Thanks, Major General. Thank you, Grandma. All of you guys. It was great.
And yay. Thank you to everyone at Everfree and everyone out there in the listening audience. It's been fabulous. And we're going to take a little break for a couple of weeks for Christmas. And then are very excited to be resuming, planning to resume on January the 12th, if you're available, Mike. I didn't actually...
I think that I will be.
Okay. And we're going to premiere our first... the goal is to premiere our first Speedy and Stretch episode on that show.
Which will be great. I mean, well, yeah. Maybe we could even call that the Speedy and Stretch episode number one, you know?
Let's do it. Without the pressure, it's not going to happen. So I'm just there. I put it out there in the digital universe, and now I have to do it.
But, you know, that's January. That's, like, next year or something. That's a million.
It is
million,
next year.
You know, just yeah. Way
and Michelle
out
was going to actually close off, too, with the little piece from today's episode, just since it was so apropos for the show that we're doing right now. But I'll let her get in the last word. So everybody else, Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas! And then the music will go dee 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 dee. Dear Princess Celestia. Okay, here we go. Dear Princess Celestia, today I learned a great lesson about family, which, if you think about it, is really the first group of friends you ever meet. Turns out that when you're with folks you care about, you don't have to do much to make that time memorable. Even the simplest of activities can take a whole lot of meaning. And you'll find that you'll remember the who long after you've forgotten the what. Yours truly, Apple. Merry Christmas! Gonna keep on dancing to the rock and roll.
I'm gonna